How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can change your IP address on Windows 10. And there are many ways to do so. Okay, so let's get straight to it. Now, the first method is how you can manually change your IP address. So you're going to go to Control Panel, just go to your search bar, hit CON, you'll find Control Panel, and just go there. Okay, hit Network and Internet. And from there, click Network and Sharing Center. From there, hit Change adapter settings. After that, you want to go to whatever your connection is, where you're getting your connection from. I am using cable connection, so I'm just going to hit properties. And after that, you want to go to TCP, okay? Internet Protocol Version 4, TCP/IPv4. Once you left click this, you want to click on properties, okay? And then use the following IP address. And this is how you can just put in your own manual IP address. Now, say you don't want or you don't know which IP address to put or and whatnot, you want to just do it automatically, no problems. So click away from everything and just hit, go to the search bar, type in CMD, okay, run as administrator, and you want to type in ipconfig, okay? So ipconfig, okay, / release. And this will disconnect your internet for a few moments. Do not panic, this is normal. So we're going to release our current IP address. And from there, once that's done, that whole text is kind of showing up and you're done with that, you wanna hit ipconfig/ renew, which will renew your IP address and it should give you a new IP address, and just hit enter. And just wait for it. It'll take a little bit of time, and that is pretty much it. Okay, so another way to do it is by obviously just simply unplugging your router. If you unplug your router, it'll just renew. Now, the thing about unplugging your router, you can't just unplug your router and put it back in. What happens when you unblock or unplug your router is that you're telling your ISP, you're kind of signaling to them that this IP address is no longer in use. And what will happen is that somebody else will get to pick up that IP address. Somebody in your region will pick up that IP address. And the next time you plug back your router, you'll get a new IP address. And that's really how it works. Sometimes it takes 5 minutes for that to happen. Sometimes it takes overnight. So yeah, just you can experiment with that and see what works for you. What you can do also is you can just call your internet service provider and ask them to change your IP address for you. Now, you know, I'm not sure why you're trying to change your IP address, but for me, if I'm trying to change my IP address, it's because I want to unblock streaming services, for example. And this is what I like to do. And the best way to change your IP address, the best and most reliable way and the most believable way to change your IP address is by using a VPN. And this is my favorite way, obviously. And I have these three VPNs for you guys. If you would like, by the way, if you're interested in any of these VPNs, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description down below, as well as full reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs with regards to their privacy policies, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Now, how do you know which one of these VPNs could be the best choice for you? It depends on what you're looking for. So if you're looking for the best of the best, you can go with ExpressVPN, especially if you're in a censorship heavy country. So that could be a reason why you're trying to change your IP address. I'm assuming maybe you don't want maybe the ISP or authorities to get after you. You don't want to leave any traces behind. Maybe you're trying to access a banned game in your region or whatever it is that you're trying to do. If you are in a censorship heavy country and if you're looking for the best of the best, just go with ExpressVPN. You've got over 3,000 servers in 94 countries and you'll be able to simultaneously secure 5 devices per subscription. And of course, you've got basic features such as the kill switch and split tunneling. I'm not going to get too much into the features of all these VPNs. If you're interested in learning more about them, just check the reviews below. But besides that, you've got the kill switch and split tunneling. The kill switch will stop your internet traffic if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly, and the split tunneling feature will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. You can just select which ones. It's a very useful feature. You've got a handful of protocols, and all these features, by the way, including, you know, a few protocols here and there, the split tunneling and kill switch feature. They're all available in all of these VPNs, okay? If you just go to the settings here, same thing. You've got quite a few protocols here. So three protocols, the kill switch, as well as an app kill switch, split tunneling, custom DNS, and just more. And it's the same with Surfshark. Obviously, just go here. You've got a handful of protocols. And if you just go back, you've got Whitelister, which is the same as split tunneling. It's just called Whitelister and Surfshark, and the kill switch, as well as an ad blocker. And you do have an ad blocker here as well. It's just called CyberSec. So yeah, pretty basic stuff. Again, you've got over 5,100 servers with NordVPN in 60 countries. So that's about 2,000 more servers, but 34 less countries. So depending on what you're looking for, you can pick and choose between Express or Nord. And if you want the best budget option with over 3,200 servers in 65 countries, you'll be able to also secure an unlimited number of devices, simultaneous devices, with just a single subscription, making it a great value option for most people. Surfshark will do a great job. And all these VPNs are able to unblock a whole bunch of streaming services, you know, US Netflix libraries and whatnot. So great stuff overall. So that'll be it for this video. This is how you change your IP address on Windows 10. If you guys have any questions, be sure to post them in the comments down below. Again, you'll find links to special deals and discounts in the description, as well as reviews if you'd like to learn more about these VPNs. Besides that, like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and see more of it. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.